Looking to grab more attention with print? Now you can combine spectacular CMYK color with the shimmer and shine of Vivid Toners together in one design. Before we get started, let's cover one simple ground rule. When you're designing for any one toner set, all the colors of that set will be perfectly registered to each other. For jobs that require two toner sets, however, create a design that doesn't rely on the two toner sets registering perfectly to each other. We'll show you what to do and what not to do using this postcard design. Let's get started. Start by deciding where embellishments will have the most impact. Stay away from embellishments that require tight color-to-color registration between toner sets. For example, it won't line up quite right if you try to trace the CMYK elephant's wrinkles with clear toner. Adding some shine to a freely floating text element, however, is a great idea. In some two-pass jobs, you may want to experiment with a base of white toner under your metallics to help them stand out even more against the CMYK underneath. Now, you're ready to set up specialty spot colors in the file. Let's start by creating the white layer of our text. When designing overlapping embellishments, work from the bottom up. Next, in your swatches palette, add a new swatch. Select 100% cyan, which is the color we're using to visually represent white. Name it S White and save it as a spot color. Fill the desired elements with your S White spot color at 100%. Now we'll add a layer for our gold and silver. Copy the white art and paste it in place. Create a new gold swatch using Pantone 871C. And name it S Gold. For silver, create a new swatch using Pantone 877C. And name it S Silver. Then, fill your desired objects. Be sure to use correct naming syntax and swatch colors for your vivid spot colors. Next, we'll set the vivid elements to multiply. Which tells the press not to leave a knockout area when it prints the first pass. A knockout could cause registration issues with the second pass. By multiplying, you can keep the entire design in one PDF rather than separating it into two. When it's time to print, export a PDF using these settings. Under Adobe PDF Preset, select Press Quality. On the Compression tab, ensure that all image types are set to Do Not Downsample. Under Output, there should be no color conversion, and the profile inclusion policy should be set to Include All RGB and Tagged Sources. Under Advanced, make sure Subset Fonts when percent of characters used is less than is set to 100%. Then click Export. It's as simple as that. Be sure to let your print provider know you've designed for the Xerox Adaptive CMYK Plus Kit and which two-toner sets you used. Looking for more design insights? Visit xerox.com/creative and keep pushing print forward with Beyond CMYK.